two kids, I have to have substitute words for these things. Normally, this person doesn't get to keep their job. We clearly live in very challenging times. But just a few months ago, I was given an impromptu speech challenge. It was, how would I change the world? And I had to think quickly, so I went to my pet passion, which is diversity. From my introduction, you can tell I am a huge proponent of diverse representation in media. So I said, I would change the world through divine intervention. No, I'm just kidding. By being the world's most unusual casting agent. And I had the audience help me by shouting out unusual characteristics for the lead, for the lead of a new superhero movie. So our superhero's body type, we decided to be a little more heavier than the usual superhero. Their gender was ambiguous. Their profession, a lawyer, and their country of origin was Guatemala. For la ley means the law in Spanish. I'm pretty proud of that name. So this went over really well, and I think we'd all totally see this movie. But on a more serious note, I kind of wonder, how much does representation matter? And so I want us to think about why the president said what he said. What picture do he and many Americans have of Africa in their heads? Because it is definitely not this. I know that growing up in the 80s and 90s, many of the books I read concerning any country in Africa tended to depict the minority of Africans who live in extreme poverty. And having kids today, I know that books and content are a lot better, yet still, at the library, I find books like this. This is Home. It's an exceedingly charming book about homes around the world. But take a guess at who lives in the humble metal shack. The Kenyan blacksmith lives in the humble metal shack. And who lives in the large country home? The Slovakian Duchess lives in the large country home. I know we are not Hollywood producers, we are not book publishers, but I have two very powerful habits that any one of us can do on an everyday basis. So can we get a show of hands of anyone who's a parent or who's aunt or uncle? All right, you can pretend to be aunts or uncles, you might be one day. So you have power, and as aunts and uncles, you have even better, your cool factor, which you lose in your. And I want you to be the world's most unusual librarian for your kids' bookshelf, for your niece and nephew's bookshelf. Because books don't have to be perfect if we diversify the gifts and the books we buy. So pick up fairy tales from Scandinavia as well as India or Guatemala. And pick up books on science, books about friendship, and read all of them. Because even though 50% of the population is female, only 40 to 30% of children's books feature female main characters. In a study from the mid-2000s, they found that about 50% of the boys, 5 to 13 that they studied, would pick up toys for boys and girls equally. That is, unless they were being watched, and they tended to pick the toys intended for boys. And so, but the thing is, it is 100% possible for us to change both of these patterns. So make the most weird, the most fun bookshelf for your kids, and show that the so-called girl toys or girl books are for boys as well. For the second habit, I know most of us probably work at companies that make a product or a service, or maybe you make presentations at work. I figure that's why many of us are here. For you, I want you to do what I call reflect the usual. Take any presentation, any marketing or product packaging that you may have worked, and any pictures or illustrations of people. Take a look at them and compare them to census data. I'm going to take the US population as one example. It is about 61% white, 18% Latino, 13% predominantly white schools in the U.S. And you can see that integration got better and better until the mid-80s when federal support of integration dropped, and then the gains started being undone. And today, schools in the U.S. are less integrated than they were in 1960. What I hear most commonly from underrepresented groups is that everyday people like us, they wish that everyday people would just befriend people outside of our usual social circles. So my last habit I request of you is to just say hello. Say hello to any of the families you know from your kids' school, even if they're not from your neighborhood. Say hello to neighbors, even if your English or their English is not so great, just say hello. And if you do recruiting at your for your teams at where the places you work, send recruiters to universities outside of the usual Harvard, MIT, Ivy League. Because as much as it hurts me to say, because I spent a lot of money on expensive schools, schools are not a very excellent indicator of how well candidates actually do in the workplace. And so before I close, I want to leave you with one anecdote. I diversified my kids, broke shelves, but I honestly wondered how impactful it was. Until one day my husband